and welcome to La Rosa Reads. I'm Denise La Rosa, and this is...
Natalie.
And this is...
Gianna.
And we are here to chat it up with you. So, let's talk books. So it's been a while since our lovely La Rosa girls have graced their presence here before you on La Rosa Reads, and quite frankly, they are sick of me. Specifically, sick of recording these videos. So we decided to make seasonal appearances and special appearances for, you know, book hauls and things like that. So this is the La Rosa Girls' first appearance of the year. I think what we're going to do today is simply talk about the books that we're currently reading. We're also going to share with you some books that we plan on reading with a special announcement attached to it. So, Gianna, let's start with you. What books have you been reading, whether it's been like at school or at home? What are you up to?
I read the first Sal and Gabby book, Sal and Gabby Break the Universe. I started to read the second one, but I listened to it on audio. And, like, the narrator sounded different because, like, it was, like, within the span of, like, 2 years, I think, that he had made the new book. So he sounded different, and I didn't like that because that was one of the reasons why I was intrigued to, like, keep on reading it because it's narration. So I kind of stopped reading that, like, the second book because I just didn't like the narrating.
Yeah, and that can happen. I know for me, I get fatigued with book series. I'm not someone who goes from like one book in the series to the next usually. So there might be a little bit of that at play as well. And what are you currently reading in school?
I'm reading The Giver.
Tell us about that.
It's about this community that's kind of like different. It's taking place like in the future and it's all black and white. And, there are a lot of strict rules. And if you do something against the law, you get released. If you want to find out what that means, read the book. And the main character's name is Jonas, and something happens to him. Read the book if you want to find that out.
Okay.
That's all I have to say.
Gotcha. So you have been having a great reading year this year in your English class, and you enjoyed the two books I feel like you enjoyed the most are Help Me Remember. What are the two books like? I just remember you being like, what is it, Terabithia something?
Bridge to Terabithia and Tuck Everlasting, I think.
Yeah, and you also loved A Midsummer Night's Dream, right?
Yeah, that was really fun.
All right, go ahead, Shakespeare. Great. That sounds exciting. What about you, Natalie? What have you been up to reading-wise?
So I've been reading Wings of Fire. I haven't really been reading it lately, but since I haven't really been reading that lately, I've been reading this new book. It's about Karen. It's Babysitter's Little Sisters, and it's the newest book. Like, I'm sorry if you're watching this, but I kind of just read it to make fun of it. I'm sorry, but...
Yes, Babysitter's Little Sister series is, like, something that you really enjoy for that reason, I've noticed. The illustrations are hilarious. Like, Karen is very
crazy
animated. Let's put it that way.
In school, so I don't really exactly remember the book I'm reading whenever, like, during silent reading, but I do know the book that I'm reading, like, learning-wise.
Okay, what's that?
Helen Keller. She pushed her baby sister out of her cradle.
Oh, okay.
Because she was in her doll's cradle.
Oh, dear. So, you're going to help me learn a lot about Helen Keller because, unfortunately, I didn't read anything about her in school for myself. Like, my own school experience, I know some key facts that are well known to people, but I really have always had the desire to learn more about her. So what do you think about the book?
So it's not just a one book that we're reading. So we're kind of like jumping between books because in different books they explain what's happening in a different way.
Oh, all about Helen Carroll.
So then whenever we answer the questions, we can answer it in a different way, in a more descriptive way.
Nice!
But we're like if we read the first book and stop at chapter 4, we're going to go to the next book and start at chapter 4.
Huh.
I remember doing that.
That's interesting. Okay. So what have you learned about Helen Keller? I heard about the story about pushing her little sister out of the crib?
Yeah, and it was her doll's crib, not Helen's, but her sister Mildred's crib.
Okay. Tell me some other things that you know about Helen Keller.
She wrote something in Braille. I don't remember what it was, like a book or like something for like blind people to read. It was in Braille. And we got to try writing in Braille.
Oh, yeah.
And I got it right on my first try.
Okay, well, good for you. Awesome. So thank you for sharing. And so here's the announcement, my love bugs. I told the girls this and they were just kind of like, what? Like, I don't even know what that means. But I have recently joined NetGalley. And for book lovers, bookish people, you know that is a resource where you can sign up to get free copies. It could be e-copies, printed copies of new releases. So you're getting ARCs, advanced reading copies of those books. And the whole purpose of you getting those is for you to read and review them and share those reviews out in the world. Social media, such as Goodreads, here on BookTube, Bookstagram. And I am so excited because we really are diving into some middle grade books for NetGalley. We have tried one with little success, but I am hopeful because the girls got a chance to request the books, and some of the ones that got approved are books that I think they're going to enjoy. So let's share those reads with you. So the Rebel Girl series that we got approved for, the book in that series, is Dr. Wangari Maathai Plants a Forest. And because she has a Pittsburgh connection, she attended the University of Pittsburgh. And I believe, Nellie, you learned about her in STEM class at school. I thought, oh, this would be a nice request. And I personally requested this one. And we've gotten through one chapter. And any thoughts you want to share, girls? Let's start with G.
It's okay. I mean, it's not the best book in the universe.
Why not? I'm curious. What is it that's not vibing with you?
Just the theme and the vibes the book is giving off. It's kind of dragging. Yeah, I just don't like it.
Okay, what about you, Nellie?
I just don't really like it.
Why? What is it about the book you don't like?
It's just like, it's kind of like dragging.
You've
just like taking so long for it to get to like the good stuff. I'm not even sure if it's even good stuff in this book, but like.
Okay, well, that makes my heart a little sad because it is based off of a real life, like a true story.
Oh, well, that's the problem. If there was a bunch of stuff going on, like a bunch of sad stuff going on, would there be good stuff?
The thing is, if you need to find, to be able to, like, write a book about somebody's life, it has to be an interesting life to write about.
Well, she does have an interesting life.
But why is it taking so long to get to it?
So I think this is one of those books that I think is, like, kind of made, like, a bedtime story, I think. So, I don't know. I think that's what's going on here with Dr. Wangari Maathai, because you learned about her in school, and she does have a very interesting story. I personally agree, as an educator and a mother, that this book has got a slow start. It's a lot of intimate moments with Mama and Dr. Maathai and her mom, and it's just eking by. You know, it is slow, but I think it's meant to be that way because it's like a little bedtime story that you can spread out over the course of however many days. Like, it's almost like reading a chapter every night kind of thing. So, and our girls, like, you all really like a lot of action. So I think this could be up someone's alley, like a little one or young person, I should say, that is really into biographies and autobiographies. That's not really y'all's thing. So I don't think that it's necessarily that the book is boring as much as it's just not your thing. I don't know. It might be a D and F for us. We have some other ones coming up that I don't know if we even have time to get into, and just, it's almost like giving you a sneak preview. We plan to discuss each of these books for an upcoming episode of La Rosa Reads. So Gianna, I know you liked The Do-Over, and I'm trying to see if there's anything else.
Stage Fright.
This is one that I just got for myself called Atlanta Fish Fry. Ooh. I just liked the cover. So, you know, we've got some nice books here on the queue that we're excited about. This NetGalley experience for the La Rosa girls looks like it's going to be a very interesting one. Will they discover a book that they fall in love with? I don't know. We are not off to the greatest of starts. Much love and respect to Dr. Wangari Maathai. We love you. This interpretation of your life story has been a struggle for us to get through, but it's no reflection upon the incredible Dr. Maathai herself. So that's my disclaimer for that. Natalie, thank you for doing this, because Natalie was like, I'm keeping these night clothes on. I am not in the mood for this. So thank you for doing what your mother and father have told you to do by being here. Gianna, thank you for being here with me today for La Rosa Reads. And what are the young people in your life reading? I would love to know. Please share with us in the comments below. We hope that we've given you some good ideas. It is middle grade March. We are here at the end of middle grade March. So we just hope you keep reading. Middle grade books are awesome, and you are too. So until next time, happy reading. Bye.
Bye.